receiving, please replace your mask before proceeding directly outside. Ushers will direct you accordingly. If you are in the parking lot and would like to receive communion at the conclusion of mass, please enter the rectory driveway from Hoosick Street. The Christian ministers will begin the driveway between the church and the garages to distribute communion, and you may exit out onto Summer Street. Our mass this morning is being offered for the people of St. John Paul II Parish. And our celebrant this morning is Father Steve.
Which church is not the Holy Spirit among us.
reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. How beautiful on mountains are the feet of the messenger who brings good news, who heralds peace, brings happiness, and proclaims salvation, and says to Zion, your God is king. Hear the voices of your watchmen. They raise their voices, shouting for joy together, for with their own eyes they have seen the Lord returning to Zion. Break into shouts together, shouts of joy, you ruins of Jerusalem, for the Lord has consoled his people, he has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm for all the nations to see, and all the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Again, this life was the light of the human race. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. A man named John was sent from God. He came to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to testify to the light, the true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came to be through him, but the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, but his own people did not accept him. But to those who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God. To those who believe in his name, who were born not by natural generation, nor by human choice, nor by a man's decision, but of God. And the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. And we saw his glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, saying, "This was he of whom I said, 'The one who is coming after me ranks ahead of me because he existed before me.' From his fullness we have all received grace in place of grace. Because while the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, the only Son, God, who is at the Father's side, has revealed him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When I was in college, and it seems like it was about 90 years ago, I had figured I was going in to the seminary, and I had been meeting with then Auxiliary Bishop Leo O'Neill, and one afternoon, as I met with him, as he lived at the Divine Mercy Shrine in Stockbridge, he excused himself at the end and said, "I'll be right back." And he came down the stairs with a book in his hand, and he said, "Stephen, this book has given me great comfort and consolation over the years. I took it with me when I went into the seminary, and it helped me through, and it continues to give me comfort and consolation." And the book written by John Lynch, and the book is entitled "A Woman Wrapped in Silence." A woman wrapped in silence. And why, I said to myself, why does this book have such an influence on Bishop O'Neill? And it's clear through the prose of the book, all human beings, we all need a deep, genuine, abiding sense of things. A full sense of things. A deep, penetrating sense of things. And the marvel of John Lynch's work was he revealed the nature of the incarnation of God in Jesus in a way I had never really read or contemplated before. And the book moves you through the eyes of God, watching Mary and Joseph prepare, watching and observing Mary, Joseph, and Jesus,
sort of come alive, and you begin to look at everything different, with a deeper spiritual faith-filled eye, and you begin to detect what is glorious to God. Is us, is the human person being human in all of its sacred magnificence that is specific and unique to every human being, and how all of this comes together in the fullness of time in and through this infant, so as to bring us through our own growing experience of what it means to experience the life and the love of God in us, and how we can appreciate what God has done, continues to do, and is forever present to us through His Son,
through the Lord Jesus.
And here is, for me, the best definition I have ever come across. Despite all the theology and everything else, and all the theological and Christological terms, that very often just goes in the left and out the right. Do you know what I mean? It's too sophisticated. It's not something that resonates on the level of soul and enters into the mind in a way that rolls around so as to feed and nourish the heart. But this does. And this is the best definition I've ever heard on the nature and the meaning of the incarnation of God in Jesus. God's way with man has been to take man's way, the glory and the scandal both. Oh, not the lifted gates and thunders he chose, and not exotic retinue to bring him flaming through the breathless town with swift compulsion and command. Not this, but grievous pausing in the pulse of life with all our old simplicities unmarred, with no rejection of the flesh we bear, the hearts we love with, the pain we know. He slept our sleep, and with us dreamed our dreams. I pray you all a most blessed Christmas, a most blessed New Year, happy, healthy to the nth degree, that we all might share ever more deeply into the glorious experience of being human in Christ. Amen.
Joyfully proclaim God's presence among us through His incarnation. us pray to the Lord. For the peace of all peoples, that they may know the light which darkness can never overpower, let us pray to the Lord. For those separated from the ones they love at this time, that the child of Bethlehem may draw them into the consoling warmth of his family feast, let us pray to the Lord. For all our families celebrating this joyful feast, that as we welcome our Savior, so we will see and welcome him in his poor, let us pray to the Lord.
this awe-filled mystery. Though invisible in his own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in ours. And begotten before all ages, he has begun to exist in time. So that rising up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and call straying humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so, with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Yes, sir.